here at the Denny Farrell Riverbank State Park Greenhouse and Kitchen Garden. And today we're going to talk a little bit about indoor watering. And you can see behind me, we have beautiful tropical plants in here in this greenhouse. And we're just going to talk a little bit about the basics. So when discussing watering with indoor plants, the first thing we need to talk about is the type of pot that you have. So over here you see a bunch of succulents and cacti, and you'll notice that most of them, if not all of them, are in ceramic pots. What a ceramic pot does is it allows these, it breathes, whereas a plastic pot does not breathe. And a ceramic pot is porous and has holes that is going to allow water to evaporate out the sides. Therefore, plants that prefer drier soil are going to want to be planted in ceramic pots. Over here you'll notice that we have all of these larger pots are in plastic. And like I mentioned, this is partly due to the fact that they like more water and can sustain wetter soils for longer periods of time because there's going to be no evaporation through the sides of the pot. Another consideration is the size of the plant. This plastic pot is going to weigh less than if we had this size pot as a ceramic pot. This is easier to move, albeit still very heavy, in a plastic pot in comparison to a ceramic pot. Another consideration to make when talking about pots and indoor plants is that they all need to have a hole at the bottom. Most plants, other than aquatic, do not want to be sitting in water. They do not want their roots to be sitting in water. This leads to root rot and then death. Overwatering your indoor plants is the number one cause of death of plants. So you always want to have a hole at the bottom, whether it's ceramic or plastic. And then what you do is you put like a small piece of ceramic or a stone or something at the bottom of the hole, so that soil doesn't come pouring out when it's planted with soil in a plant. How do you know if your plant needs water? There's a number of things to consider when thinking about your plant's water needs. The type of plant, which we mentioned before, succulents and cacti don't need lots of water. They hold it in their leaves and in their stems and in their roots. Whereas more herbaceous plants need more water. You're also going to consider where in your house you have them placed. If they're close to a radiator in the winter, it's going to dry out, will need more water. If it's close to the window with sunlight and it's getting lots of sun, it's going to need more water. Another consideration is the time of year. When the plant is in its growth spurt and its time of growth, it wants more water. When it's more active, it wants more water, and therefore when it's going slowing down and going into dormancy, the watering needs will also shift. So that said, we look here at all of these beautiful plants, and we don't know which ones need water. One way to go about it is literally just picking up your pot and feeling the weight of it. This pot is very heavy, and so I would guess that this plant doesn't need water. If the pot is light, then it would need water most likely. And this has to do with the fact that water weighs something. And so when the soil is dry and has no moisture, it weighs less than when it has moisture. Let me see if I can find one that needs some water. So we look here, and another way to be able to tell if a plant needs water is using your finger. You stick your finger into the soil, about 2 inches, and you notice if it's moist or not. If it's not moist 2 inches down, you can give your herbaceous plant some water. The top of the soil is going to be a little bit drier most likely, and again, that's due to evaporation. So this plant is in need of a little bit of water. When watering plants, either inside or outdoors, you want to make sure you're watering the base of the plant. Leaves do not absorb water. The part of the plant that does absorb water is the roots. The roots are down in here. So we want to make sure we get all the water down towards the roots. this watering can, and we just go around the plant making sure to get the soil entirely surrounding the plant. You want to be aware of the movement of soil through the force of the water, as well as making sure it absorbs. When soil is very, very dry, it'll take a little while for it to be able to absorb the water, and it may just puddle at the top until it starts to absorb. How do you know when you have enough water? Again, you can do the lifting up. If it got heavier, then you have enough water. You're also looking for it to come out the bottom of the pot. So I'm going to use this watering can now, which I actually think is more ideal for indoor watering because it's a more focused spout. We're going to water again, making sure to get all the way around, not moving the soil around too much. And then again, waiting to see if we have some coming out the bottom. There it goes. Drip, 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 drip. Okay. So something that happens, so it comes out the bottom, and then you might think, I'm done. And I will say, you're not. I would do another watering. You know, let it absorb, do another watering. And then let that drip out the bottom as well. When soil is too dry, again, the water will just pass right through without being absorbed. You want to encourage your plant to develop deep roots. The deeper and more robust the root system, the stronger and healthier your plant's going to be. If you only water a little bit and the soil only gets moist down to the first 2 inches or so, the roots are going to stay at this level. This is the same for outdoors as well. So you want to water all the way down to the bottom of the pot so that the roots are encouraged to grow deep down into the bottom of the pot.